Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel. I hope everyone is safe and healthy. Today we are going to discuss a very crucial topic, the topic of total cost of ownership. And I know many of you would have this dilemma in your head that which one do you choose, the Ather 450x or a normal traditional IC engine driven 125cc scooter. Now why we are taking 125cc scooter is because this is a performance scooter. In terms of pricing, it is very clear that the initial investment of the Ather 450x is way higher than a traditional 125cc scooter. But we need to understand how it impacts the total cost of ownership in the coming 5 years. So for explaining this scenario, we are going to consider the ex-showroom Delhi prices. So the Ather 450x cost 1.3 lakhs ex-showroom Delhi, and a traditional 125cc scooter will cost you somewhere around 85,000 ex-showroom Delhi. So there is a big difference of 45,000 rupees between the initial cost. We are not going to consider the insurance cost because the insurance cost for both the scooters is almost the same. Now the second cost after initial investment is the running cost. So for example, if your office is somewhere around 10 to 15 kilometers away, you'll be doing a round trip of 30 kilometers, and on top of it is shopping and some other city commute work. So we are taking a rough estimate of 250 kilometers per week for both the scooters. Now with that consideration, you'll be doing 1000 kilometers a month, and the Ather requires 13 full charges because it does 80 kilometers in one full charge, and one full charge is just 3 units. So that means 30 rupees per charge. So that makes your monthly costing for the Ather 450x to roughly around 400 rupees for 1000 kilometers. Whereas on the other hand, if you are using a traditional 125cc scooter, it will give you a mileage of somewhere around 40 kmpl, which will make you spend somewhere around 25 liters of fuel in a month. And currently we all know that the petrol charges are hovering between 105 to 110 rupees per liter, and they are not going to go down anytime soon. So we are taking a rough estimate of 100 rupees per liter, and that brings your costing to 2500 rupees per month. On top of it, for the first year you have the servicing free, but then you have to pay for the consumable. That adds up a cost of 500 rupees per service for the first year, and you do usually 3 services a year. So the effective cost of running a 125cc scooter is around 2600 rupees a month. That makes the calculation very simple because the Ather is costing 40 paisa per kilometer, whereas the 125cc scooter is costing you 2 rupees 60 paisa per kilometer. So when we consider the complete year, the Ather 450x costs you just 4800 rupees a year, whereas the traditional 125cc scooter will cost you 31,000. So if you are able to grab that deal, you are going to break even in the first year itself. And if you bought the scooter in the right price itself, the second year will help you out because the maintenance for 125cc scooter will gradually rise second year onwards. Now there are few things that are common in both the scooters, like the brake liner, brake pads and the tires. So we have not considered it as part of maintenance for both the scooter to make the calculation simple. The only additional cost that you have to bear on the 450x is the cost of connectivity. You have 2 plans to choose from, 1600 per year or 2400 per year, and both of them are totally optional. So if you want, you can just give away that connectivity and save your money. So that was it from our end, and after 2 years, every penny that you are burning on your 125cc scooter, you could have saved on your Ather 450x, and that is what we have to think, because EV is the future. I hope this video was helpful for you. Do give it a thumbs up, share it with your family and friends, and if you're new to our channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and ring that bell so you never miss out great content from Rev Explorers. We are also available on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter, so if you have any doubts or any queries, you can directly get in touch with us on our social media pages or leave it in the comment section below. We'll try to respond to you as soon as possible. We'll see you again in the next video. Till that time, stay home, stay safe and ride safe. Bye bye.